Long, slithery, and slippery. Some even come with venom-tipped fangs. The general consensus is that snakes are anything but the perfect cuddle-buddle. Thankfully, though, if you have ophidiophobia, we won't be traumatizing you today by showing you footage of the sorts of snakes you could find in your garden or toilet. You'll be happy to know that the snakes we are about to show you are anything of common. So no matter how scared you are, at least it's unlikely you'll ever meet them in real life, but you won't be happy to know. That doesn't mean they're any less terrifying. These are the rarest snakes in the world. Number 15. San Francisco Garter Snake. The San Francisco Garter Snake is a multicolored species of snake that can be found mainly around San Mateo County in California. It's a subspecies of the common garter snake, but to see one of them for yourself requires some luck. It's rarer than you might think. They were designated as being endangered in 1967, and today it's believed that there are no more than about 2,000 of them still alive in the wild. Growing up to 55 inches long, they have blue-green dorsal scales and stripes of blacks, reds, oranges, and blues along the rest of their bodies. Unusually, their red heads are rarely wider than their necks, and they have much larger eyes than are common in snakes.
Such a beautiful snake in California.
Which gives them that extremely good eyesight for hunting during the day. Their main source of food comes from aquatic species such as frogs, bullfrogs, and newts, and as a result, they live around ponds and areas of stagnant water, where they can also lie in the sunlight and hide in burrows. As their population numbers continue to fall, it's illegal to try and catch or kill one of them, and there are concerns about whether the continual development of the land around their habitat will, one day, lead to them becoming extinct. Like this video, smash the subscribe button and click the notification bell right now, or Slenderman will come from under your bed when you're sleeping. Now it's time for the juicy topic. The reason why we have chosen this photo as our juicy topic today is because it is the only snake in the video. We can't be 110% confident it exists for sure, but the myths and legends around it sure are convincing. Personally, we think it might be real. And we're excited to hear what you think, be it Cerberus from Greek mythology or a fluffy dog from Harry Potter. The world of fiction has often given us three-headed beasts, but could one be real? Well, if it is, it seems the most likely candidate is not a dog, but a cobra. Two-headed snakes are actually more common than you might think. While still rare, roughly 1 in 100,000 snakes have a second head and are considered a sign of impending disaster in many cultures. And some photographers have even snapshots of three-headed snakes, normally cobras. The photograph you are looking at now is one such photo. Many of these images are swiftly shot down as fakes, but given how common two-headed snakes are, surely there might be at least one real three-headed snake out there? Scientists certainly think it's possible. Albeit unlikely, for what it's worth, this particular photo has yet to be shot down. Where do you stand? Is this a photo of a real three-headed cobra, or is it a fake? And if you do think it is a fake, do you think three-headed cobras could exist, or do you think two-headed is the limit? All we know is this: the man who took this photo insists it is real, and has been aggressively fighting his corner ever since. Comment down below with the hashtag #JuicyTopic and let us know your opinion in relation to what we just showed on screen. With that said, let's keep things moving. Number 14. Rainbow Snake. As their name would suggest, rainbow snakes are some of the most brightly colored serpents you'll ever see. But due to historical capture and habitat loss, it's highly unlikely you'll ever encounter one in real life. Their colors are almost unreal. They have blue and black scales along their backs, three red stripes, and can also develop yellow scales too. No two rainbow snakes have the same color configuration, although those that are more closely related have more similar patterns. They are endemic to the southeastern US, and there were originally two subspecies, although one has now already been declared extinct. Adults can grow up to 48 inches long and spend the vast majority of their lives in water, seeking cover from threats in the vegetation. Even if one is nearby, it can be almost impossible to see because of their ability to camouflage in with the surroundings, and they're also able to burrow into sand or mud to hide even more. They hunt eels, frogs, salamanders, and tadpoles, and capture and eat their prey alive, usually swallowing them head first. They are non-venomous and surprisingly calm when handled by humans, which is part of the reason why so many have been captured for display. Number 13. Wagner's Viper. The critically endangered Wagner's viper is a species of snake that is native to eastern Turkey and across the border into northwestern Iran. It gets its name from the first explorer to capture a specimen in 1846, Moritz Wagner, and has taken on somewhat of a legendary status in the region because of its rarity. They live in the mountains at altitudes of between 5,200 and 6,200 feet, and tend to stick to the undergrowth whenever possible. They are venomous, although not particularly dangerous to humans, and they use their toxins to kill small mammals and birds that they can then take their time to eat. Wagner's vipers grow up to 37 inches long, and they are a grayish brown with lighter colored blotches along their bodies. Normally, there are stretched blotches on their heads that look like a V-shape, and they often also have a stripe that runs from the corners of each eye to their mouths. The main reason this species is threatened is because of their capture for sale as pets, and because of the construction of dams in the region that have destroyed large amounts of their natural habitat. Conservation programs take place in zoos around the world, such as the one in St. Louis, where 9 were born in 2013. Number 12. Golden Lancehead Viper. The golden lancehead viper is a species of pit viper that is believed by many to be the most venomous and deadly snake in the world. It's a good thing, then, that they only live on one small island, offshore from São Paulo State in Brazil, so humans very rarely have to deal with them. The island separated from the mainland tens of thousands of years ago, which meant that this species evolved independently to its close relations on the continent. They have very few food sources, but the island is the resting place for flocks of birds, and this is why the venom has become so powerful. The snakes have a limited time in which to bite their prey, and the effects of the toxin have to be fast-acting to ensure it dies before it has flown too far away.
Resident birds know to avoid the snakes.
Growing up to 48 inches long, there are thought to be several thousand of them on the 43-acre Snake Island, but very few studies have ever taken place to know for sure. The Brazilian Navy has set up a perimeter around it to stop people visiting, all because the golden lanceheads are so dangerous. Their venom contains hemotoxins that melt flesh to aid them with eating their prey, and soon will lead to nausea, intestinal bleeding, kidney failure, hemorrhage in the brain, and eventually death if not treated. This is definitely one species where fortunate is rare. Number 11. White Cobra. Snakes are normally colored to blend in with their surroundings, but there are two conditions that can affect them, which means that their bodies lack pigment albinism and leucism. All snake species can be born with either of these, and it's thought to be far more common in them than any other type of animal. Despite this, they are incredibly rare, mainly because, without their camouflage, it's much more difficult for them to effectively hunt, and it's much easier for predators to find them. White cobras are some of the most amazing ones to see, and they are otherwise no different from normal cobras. They still have the telltale hood and potent venom, but are, though too seldom, live past the second day after they've hatched. The gene that causes this is a recessive one, which means that two normal colored snakes are able to produce them as offspring, but it won't occur in all of their eggs. In the wild, as they are extremely likely to live to adulthood, there are no known instances of two white snakes mating. But if they were to, all of their newborns would also be white. Albino and leucistic snakes are particularly sought after as pets, but for a healthy one, it can cost many times the amount of a normal colored one. Number 10. Double-headed snakes. They say two heads are better than one, but in the case of snakes, this isn't always necessarily true. There's a condition called polycephaly that is more common in them than most other animals, and this can result in them being born with more than one head. This unusual formation begins in the embryo and happens for the same reason that conjoined twins do. There's a fault in the way the cells split in a single egg, and this leads to the development of two or more heads. The chances of survival of each individual depend on the extent to which the polycephaly has taken place.
Давайте тогда не будем это трогать.
Sometimes only one of the heads is truly viable and has to carry around the dead weight, while in other specimens, both heads will have a brain, throat, and stomach. And although they may disagree on which direction to go, they have a higher likelihood of survival. It's still difficult for them, though, and most die at a very young age. This rarity has meant that they command an extraordinarily high price to collectors, and in 2000, one was put up for sale for $150,000. A zoo in southern Ukraine recently put a two-headed king snake on display, and this one, according to officials, has heads that think and react independently to one another, and even fight over the same pieces of food. Because of this, they've had to put a barrier between the two heads when they're feeding them, and for fear that one may actually try to eat the other when they're particularly hungry. Number 9. Antiguan racers. Native to the Caribbean islands of Antigua and Barbuda, Antiguan racers were once a prevalent species, but following the introduction of predators such as mongooses and rats when settlers arrived on ships in the 19th century, their numbers plummeted. In 1995, there were only estimated to be 50 individuals still alive in the wild, making them by far one of the rarest snake species in the world. But a concerted conservation's effort has managed to turn this around in recent years. They grow to be around 3 feet long and can be a wide range of colors, such as white, red, brown, and black in all shades. They are a gentle species and pose no threat to humans at all. Feeding mainly on lizards at night, their coloration means that they look like fallen leaves, so they will typically hide in the undergrowth until a meal walks past, and then will leap into action. Antiguan racers have now been introduced to some of the smaller Antiguan islands where they once lived, and after removing the invasive predators from these pieces of land, the snakes have begun to thrive once more. The most recent survey estimates there to be around 1,100 of them now. While this by no means implies that the species has recovered, it's a good first step and shows how successful conservation programs can be. Number 8. Saharan Horned Viper. The Saharan Horned Viper lives in the deserts of Africa and the Middle East, and has long been hunted by locals because of the potential danger that they pose. They're a species of pit viper, so have a potent venom that will soon lead to swelling, nausea, necrosis, and the thinning of blood, and can cause death on rare occasions. They are easily recognizable because of their distinct horn-like structures that point up from above their eyes. But some specimens have also been found that don't have the horns for some reason. They can grow to be up to 33 inches long, and are usually yellow, gray, red, or brown in color, which helps them blend into the desert environment. They're usually found around oases and prefer smooth sand or soil. They lay in wait under rocky outcrops and will strike when their prey, such as birds or rodents, pass by. They sink their teeth in and hold on tight until the venom has done its job, leaving them to slowly devour the meal. Because of the remote regions where they live, it's not known how many there are in the wild, but they have been hunted to near extinction around human communities. And it's believed that they are threatened elsewhere too, as a result of habitat change. Number 7. Malagasy Leaf-Nosed Snake. Undoubtedly one of the most particular-looking snakes in the world, Malagasy leaf-nosed snakes are endemic to Madagascar, where they can be found in the trees of the forests. The largest specimens have been measured to be approximately 4 feet long, and you can differentiate the sexes by their coloration. Males are mainly brown with yellow along their sides and a long snout, while females are gray with a leaf-shaped snout. It's not entirely clear what evolutionary advantage their unusual head shapes have, but it has been suggested that, when laying in wait for a meal, other animals can find it hard to tell the difference between the snakes and the leaves in the trees. Their diet is made up almost entirely of tree-dwelling lizards, and they have a mild venom that assists them in hunting. This causes severe pain in humans, but no serious complications have ever been documented. They're a rare, docile species when they come into contact with people, but this is becoming increasingly rare because of their dwindling numbers. Climate change and habitat destruction are the two main causes of this, and they are on the IUCN list of threatened species that may soon become extinct if no remedial action is taken. Number 6. Short-nosed snake. Short-nosed sea snakes grow to be around 24 inches long and live in the waters off the coast of northwestern Australia. They have small, pointed heads and have brown bodies with purple-colored bands. They typically live and hunt in water that's more than 33 feet deep, but will rest in shallower waters underneath coral overhangings to hide from predators. This doesn't, however, mean that they can breathe underwater, and they need to return to the surface for oxygen every 2 hours. To make this possible, they have one lung that's almost the length of their entire body, and they're also able to absorb oxygen through their skin. These snakes are highly venomous and mainly hunt eels and gobies. The challenges facing the Australian reefs are affecting the short-nosed sea snakes. Just like many other marine creatures. And for a while, they were believed to be extinct. It was thought that they would only breed on one specific reef, where they hadn't been seen for more than 15 years. But recently, specimens have been sighted elsewhere, which suggests that there are other breeding populations that are still alive. Still, their numbers are far less than even a few decades ago, and it's very unlikely you'll see one when diving in the region. Number 5. Round Island Boa. Around 15 miles to the north of Mauritius is Round Island, a place that has been designated as a nature reserve since 1957. It's the only place in the world where Round Island boas exist in the wild, and they have been so close to extinction that in 1996, it's thought that there were only 250 mature individuals left. Recent conservation efforts, such as removing some predators and providing safe hiding spots for them, means that these numbers have now increased to around 1,000. But there are still serious concerns about the species' long-term viability. The non-venomous snakes can grow to be about 5 feet long, and they prey on geckos and skinks. To do this, they have an adaptation not seen in any other vertebrates. They have a split jaw that allows them to open their mouths extremely wide. They are dark brown with occasional lighter blotches, but their scales actually change color depending on the time of day. They are darker during the day, when they're asleep and hiding, while at night their polychromatic skin cells become lighter while they are hunting. Number 4. Aruba Island Rattlesnakes. Aruba Island rattlesnakes are, of course, found on the Caribbean island of Aruba, and it's the only place in the world where they're known to live in the wild. They grow to around 3 feet long and are known for their brown and unusually pinkish color, which allows them to camouflage into the terrain. They have some darker brown diamond markings, which often can be virtually impossible to see, and some individuals also have dark stripes along their backs. This species feeds on rodents, birds, and lizards, and are a type of pit viper, which means they lie in wait for their opportunity and then pounce at their prey with their venomous bite. As they are restricted to the dry southern tip of Aruba, there's very little habitat left for them to survive. Currently, it's estimated that only 230 remain, making it one of the most critically endangered species of snake in the world. And there's no sign of this situation improving. The main issue is the approach of human developments, which aren't slowing down, and the fact that while it's illegal to export the snakes from the island, it's perfectly legal to capture or kill them while you're there. Unless these rules change, it's probable that this species of rattlesnake will soon become extinct. Number 3. Long-nosed Viper. Originally, long-nosed vipers were found across southern Europe, and while its numbers have recently been falling, it remains the most dangerous viper on the continent, thanks to its extremely long fangs and toxic venom. Individuals have been measured up to 38 inches long. They have single brown horns on their heads, and their snouts extend much farther than other similar species. The males are dark brown, gray, or black, and have a V marking on the backs of their heads. The females, on the other hand, don't have the V mark and tend to be paler colors than the males. They tend to live in dry, rocky hillsides, but will also hide in the rubble that's being left behind from construction projects. Their main source of food is small mammals and birds, but they are considered to be non-aggressive unless provoked. While their venom could be seen as being dangerous to people, it's human behavior that's having a far greater effect on the long-nosed viper. Habitat destruction is the primary cause for their loss in numbers, and they're currently a strictly protected species to try and help their populations recover. Number 2. Tiger Keelback Snake. Tiger keelbacks are native to East and Southeast Asia and have the honor of being the only species of snake that is both venomous and poisonous. Its venom is delivered through fangs at the back of its mouth, which means a successful strike is more difficult than for snakes that have them at the front, but a bite can be enough to kill a human if the conditions are right. Their main preys are frogs and toads, and it's from these that they get their unusual means of defense. They are immune to the poison that is secreted by the toads and, instead, are able to collect it in two glands in their necks. Potential predators will be all too aware of this danger, and often will choose to leave the snake alone. They grow up to 39 inches long, and can be identified by their olive-green scales with orange and black markings. Due to hunting for food and widespread habitat destruction, however, their population numbers have been significantly falling over the past 50 years, and they're on the cusp of being declared extremely vulnerable. Number 1. Dragon Snake. Native to Thailand, Bermuda, and Indonesia, dragon snakes are a nocturnal, non-venomous species that feeds almost exclusively on frogs. They have unusually reactionary behavior when confronted by predators, and each one that's been kept in captivity has died soon after. Upon approaching one of these snakes, their initial instinct is to pretend to be a branch. They stiffen their entire bodies in as straight a line as possible and will remain like this even if they are picked up. It's possibly because of this reaction that they are quite easy for predators and hunters to catch, and they are now considered to be extremely rare across the region. There are no estimates as to how many remain, and there aren't currently any conservation efforts underway because very little is known about them. All attempts at captive breeding have failed. Some researchers have suggested that they may be entirely extinct within a matter of years if nothing is done about the habitat destruction and hunting. But with very little appetite to change the law surrounding this species, their outlook is bleak. Which of these rare snakes would you be most worried to encounter? And have you ever seen one of them yourself? Make sure to let us know in the comments section. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on the screen right now. See you next time!